Hi everyone, I'm Ben from Freemius. So, you've created an awesome WordPress plugin or theme that you're certain will forever change the ecosystem as we know it. Congratulations, but now what? We all know that creating a WordPress product is just the first step in a very long journey, and the top priority is getting users to start using it. At this point, many developers might wonder, is the WordPress.org repository really worth the hassle? Many of the advantages of the repo are obvious, like easy distribution and access to millions of users. But what many developers don't realize is that WordPress.org has a few substantial drawbacks hiding under the surface. So, to help you make the best decision for your business, let's plug in! Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for future videos. If you're watching this directly on YouTube, you can click the alert icon for notifications about new releases. The WordPress repository enables many developers to list and distribute their plugins or themes at no cost. Anyone from indie developers to large companies with dozens of employees can submit their plugin or theme to the repo and get access to new users. One of the great things about the repo is that all the plugins and themes submitted must be free of charge. This attracts millions of potential users who flock to the repository every day looking for free products that will make their websites look and perform better. And this is exactly where the business opportunity lies. If users download and like your product, they might want to upgrade to its paid version. This is what is known as the freemium pricing model. The WordPress.org repository is considered as the best place for plugin and theme developers to leverage the freemium model because of its enormous exposure to a vast and diverse audience. The benefits of submitting your plugin or theme to the repo don't end there. Distributing the light version of your product for free and sharing it with the community will allow you to receive important feedback like bug reports to improve your product. The repository is built as a collaborative platform for receiving comments and feedback and allowing you to provide support on public forums. On top of that, people that like your product can even give you reviews and tell you what feature they would like to have developed, opening more opportunities for adjusting your product specifically to users' needs. Having these eyes on your product can help you make great improvements, since it's easy to become code blind to your own creations without a fresh external perspective. Plus, the repository can serve as a great catalyst for speeding up the development and debugging process. Finally, since WordPress.org is considered as the official plugins and themes repository, and all products listed there go through a review process, there is a strong perception in the community that products listed on the repo can be trusted. Whether that's true or not can sometimes be a challenge, but regardless, this notion still makes many people come to the repo first when they need new plugins or themes. So, if it's so good, what are the problems with the WordPress.org repository? When digging under the surface and spending time inside the system, a few flaws start to surface. If you want your product to be hosted on WordPress.org, you'll have to comply with a very strict set of guidelines for your product to be approved. For example, at this point in time, themes are prohibited from having a top-level menu item in the WordPress admin dashboard and only allowed to have a sub-menu item under the appearance section. While this may not sound like a biggie, it restricts the theme's settings visibility and limits your commercial opportunities. While plugins are allowed to contain almost any functionality, when it comes to themes, you'll find yourself extremely constrained and most of your creativity will have to be in the layout and design, as anything beyond that is considered plugin territory. That's why many theme developers are now offering companion plugins that enrich the theme's functionality and recommend them to be installed along with the theme. In addition, the guidelines keep changing all the time, so you'll have to fall in line with the guidelines, or you risk finding your product being suspended from the repo. And anyone can get suspended. Take Zurich Flight, for example, which was one of the most popular themes on WordPress.org with over 300 active installs. The theme ended up being suspended from the repository, diminishing $35,000 per month of the company's revenue. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. On the second part of this series, we'll dive even deeper into the challenges a developer might face when submitting a plugin or theme to the WordPress.org repository. In the meantime, subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time. You've created an awesome WordPress plugin or theme that you're certain to list and distribute the plugins or themes at no cost. From anyone, and all products listed there go through a review process, there's a strong prescription. And this is. In the meantime, subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time.